In this video, we simplify the following 8 problems. This is part 2 of complex numbers. In part 1, we introduced and defined I. We defined the square roots of negative numbers, which were called pure imaginary numbers. And we discussed complex numbers in standard form, identifying their real and imaginary parts. Before working some new problems, let's remember a few things. Square root of negative 1 is written as I, that's what it equals, and I squared equals negative 1. So those are the definitions of I. Now, working with square roots of negative numbers, you have to make sure you first rewrite in the form BI. So we're not going to leave a negative number underneath the square root sign. Here's a property from square roots. If a and b are positive, then the square root of a times the square root of b equals square root of ab. Warning, a and b have to be positive to use this property. And lastly, if you have the square root of x times the square root of x, it's always x. It really doesn't matter if x is positive or negative. This will always be true. And another way of writing the same thing, of course, is writing the square root of x quantity squared. That also equals x. So now, keeping these in mind, we're going to try some problems. All right, we're going to simplify using the rules and properties I just went over. All right, so try this one, square root of negative 50. Put the video on pause and try it by yourself first. Okay, the first thing we need to do is write that as square root of 50i, or if you want, you can put the I out in front. Remember, it's up to you which way you want to do it. Now, instead of writing square root of 50, I'm going to go ahead and write that as a perfect square of 25 times 2 instead of writing 50. You could do that on your next step if you'd like. And then square root of 25 is a perfect square, so it gets out, okay, of the square root. So I'm going to have 5i square roots of 2. The other way to write that is 5 square roots of 2i. Just make sure that the I is not underneath that square root symbol. Here's another one for you to try, 5 square roots of negative 45. Put the video on pause and try that one. Okay, remember first we have to deal with this negative sign under the square root. So I'm going to keep the 5 there, and I'm going to do the square root of 45i. And again, I'm going to put the I in front first, just so it's sort of out of the way. And 45 could be written as 9 times 5. I'm writing it as a perfect square. So I could take the square root of 9 out, becomes a 3. So what does that give me on the outside? I have 5 times 3, which is 15. I square roots of 5. Or you could write that as 15 square roots of 5i. Just be careful that you don't put the I underneath the square root. Now, notice something important here. When you take the square root of a negative number, the answer is not negative. It's complex. It's an imaginary number. If we started out with a minus sign out in front, like a negative 6 square root of negative 9, then we can write the negative 6 times, now, we've got square root of negative 9, that'll be an I times the square root of 9, right? Which is 3. So we've got negative, I'm going to take this out right here. So negative 6 times 3 is negative 18 I. This is not a negative number. This is still a complex number. It's an imaginary number, and the coefficient is negative 18. The imaginary part is negative 18. It's not a negative number. When you talk about something being negative and positive numbers, we're basically talking about real numbers. So the coefficient is negative 18 of this, you know, the coefficient of I, you could think of it that way. Keep in mind these rules up at the top here. Remember, I stands for the square root of negative 1, so I squared equals negative 1. And to simplify the square root of a negative number, we write the square root of the positive number times I. Remember the rules for multiplying square roots. The numbers under the square root must be positive in order to multiply them together. But then if you have the square root of x times square root of x, it's always equal to x. Doesn't matter what x is. So let's look at this problem. Square root of negative 11 times square root of negative 11. Let's use the first rule up here. I can write that as the square root of 11i times the square root of 11i. And then square root of 11 times the square root of 11 will just be 11. And I've got I times I, which is I squared. Okay, now what's I squared? That's negative 1. So I have 11 times negative 1, which is negative 11. Well, that happens to match this third property, this one property down here. When I have square root of x times square root of x, you would think the answer should be negative 11, and in fact it is. But we can only use that property if we have the same number underneath the square root. Otherwise, you always have to remember to rewrite it as the square root of the positive number times I. Now, with that in mind, I want you to try square root of negative 41 times square root of negative 41. What will the answer be for this problem? Well, you can go through exactly the same steps as I did for square root of negative 11. And you could take four steps to get that the answer is negative 41, or you could use this property here, square root of x times square root of x equals x. They both lead you to the correct answer of negative 41. But what you really have to watch out for is what if it is not the same number underneath the square root? If not, we absolutely must rewrite it as the square root of the number that's positive times the I. So we're going to do some problems like that now. All right, here's the tricky problem. Now remember, if b is greater than 0, then the square root of negative b is the same thing as the square root of b times I. And only if a and b are both greater than 0, then the square root of a times the square root of b equals the square root of ab. Keep both of those in mind and try this problem on your own. Square root of negative 2 times square root of negative 8. Okay, what we have to do is use this first property at top first. So the square root of negative 2 is the same thing as the square root of 2i. The I is not under the square root. And the square root of 8, negative 8, is the same thing as the square root of 8 times I. So now, since underneath the square root I have positive numbers, I can multiply those together, which is the square root of 16. And then I've got I times I, that's I squared. The square root of 16 is 4. I squared is equal to negative 1. So this equals negative 4. Okay, now, the most common mistake is for people to say that square root of negative 2 times the square root of negative 8 is the square root of 16, which is 4. And this is wrong. Can't do that. It's actually equal to negative 4. Here are two problems for you to try. Be careful and make sure you use the rules properly. So put the video on pause and try these. All right, so anything that has a negative number under the square root, we need to rewrite. So I'm going to write this the square root of 6i times the square root of 10i. And see where I'm going to get that I times I or I squared? But let's deal with the 6 and 10 now. I'm going to write that. You could write it as 60 and then factor. I'm going to write it in factored form. So 6 is 3 times 2, and 10 is 2 times 5. And then I times I on the outside of the square root will be your I squared. So for these two 2's inside, one gets out. So one 2 gets out. Now what about this I squared? What does that mean? That means times negative 1. And then underneath the square root, I have 3 times 5. So my answer here will be negative 2 square roots of 15. And the last one over here we could write as square root of 18i over square root of 2. And now square root of 18 over square root of 2 is simply the square root of 9i or 3i. All right, so we'll do some more problems on the next video.